It's that time again. Fantastic DOS games that I've encountered in the last 100 episodes of a random DOS game show. Let's go! Number 25. Ignition. Despite having issues with a graphical bug that would cause my vehicle to repeatedly explode, even I could see why Ignition was a great game. A third-person 3D racer that has you zooming around glorious tracks in hectic fashion, with a lovely soundtrack and plenty of crazy jumps. Well worth a play for some arcade-style racing fun. Number 24. Jazz Jackrabbit. Imagine if Sonic the Hedgehog was a green rabbit, and instead of constantly chasing for rings, he had a massive gun and a hatred of turtles. That's Jazz, a great side-scrolling shooter meets platformer that proved to the world that DOS platforming could live up to the standards of contemporary consoles. Number 23. Shadowcaster. A young and hungry Raven Software team up with Origin, with a little help from John Carmack, to make an intriguing, albeit dated, first-person RPG hybrid with fiddly menu systems, player stats, and the ability to shapeshift into different creatures entirely depending on the task at hand. A sadly overlooked title, and one that would have been an absolute blockbuster if it had just been developed on id Tech 1 instead. Number 22. Seek and Destroy. Rather than being a simple top-down shooter but with a helicopter instead of a spaceship, Seek and Destroy offers 360 degrees of turning and a radar. Despite these additions, it doesn't overcomplicate matters. Rescue prisoners of war, save scientists, and spend the rest of your time destroying everything in sight. Number 21. Death Rally. Death Rally is a fast-paced top-down vehicular destruction racer, in which you participate in tournaments, upgrade your car, and grind your way to victory against a ruthless AI over a great variety of tracks, where one false move can spell complete disaster for your ruthless ambitions. Number 20. Ecstatica. Simply bizarre, an absolute nightmarish fever dream of a game, wherein you're tasked with finding out what happened to a town overrun with evil creatures. The art style is strange, featuring lots of spherical, untextured shapes, but with full voice acting and borrowing heavily from Alone in the Dark in the gameplay area, Ecstatica should please vintage horror fans. Number 19. Little Big Adventure. Featuring a similar rotational movement system as the previous game, but with an action menu and an isometric perspective, this charming action-adventure RPG hybrid has a lighter tone despite your initial imprisonment. Fight your way free of captivity by lumbering around like Frankenstein, or sneak your way past the guards and use your creativity to disguise yourself as one of them. An excellent little title worth seeking out. Number 18. Chuck Yeager's Air Combat. Despite my fear of taking on complex flight sims without a manual, my time with Chuck Yeager's Air Combat was a game of two halves. After constantly fighting just to stay in the air, I soon took to the intuitive controls and helpful advice from the war veteran, and can confidently state that this is one of the best DOS flight combat sims ever. Number 17. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. The second text-based adventure game to make it onto these lists, Hitchhikers is a spectacular romp through the unparalleled genius of Douglas Adams. It's also very easy to die, so unless you've got an FAQ or some save states, you can expect to be mercilessly cut down repeatedly until you learn from your mistakes. Just don't forget your towel. Number 16. Black Thorn. Little known Blizzard Entertainment decided they were tired of porting other people's games and started to make originals of their own. This turned out to be an idea worth billions of dollars, but they didn't know it when they made the likes of Black Thorn, a smooth side-scrolling platformer with shooter elements, where you single-handedly save your people from brutish oppressors that are one part Lovecraftian horrors and one part orc. Thank you, friend. Number 15. Centurion, Defender of Rome. Rome Total War is one of my favourite games of all time. I've since discovered that it's an utterly shameless rip-off of Centurion, Defender of Rome. The turn-based overworld map that you guide your troops through and the city management therein is literally decades ahead of its time. Not to mention the real-time combat engine that lets you watch your Romans conquer the great unwashed tribes. True to Caesar! Number 14. Scorched Earth. Some games rely on flashy presentation to sell themselves, often making up for suspect gameplay. See every other modern game released. Others have almost no presentation skills whatsoever and focus on being a pure distillation of everything good about their genre. Scorched Earth is undoubtedly the latter, perfecting the artillery game to a ludicrous degree. A group called Team 17 would apply graphical updates to their formula and reap the benefits with a game called Worms. Fans of that need to check this out pronto. Number 13. Loom. You mean the latest masterpiece of fantasy storytelling from Lucasfilm's Brian Moriarty? Why, it's an extraordinary adventure with an interface of magic, stunning high-resolution 3D landscapes, sophisticated score, and musical effects. Not to mention the detailed animation and special effects, elegant point-and-click control of characters, objects, and magic spells. Beat the rush. Go out and buy Loom today. Number 12. Raptor, Call of the Shadows. If top-down DOS shooters was an Olympic race rather than a genre, then Tyrion would edge just into the lead in the final straight, with Raptor bearing down on it every step of the way. Raptor, Call of the Shadows is a top-down vertical shooter that has no pretenses about its difficulty. You have to grind your way through a series of increasingly hard levels and upgrade and repair your ship with the money you've made to stand a chance. No health regeneration, no gimmicks, just pure top-down destruction of the best kind. Number 11. Full Throttle. Biker Ben has lost his gang and is framed for the murder of a motorcycle mogul. It's a LucasArts point-and-click adventure developed by Tim Schafer, which automatically makes it good. But the stellar voice cast and stylized graphics help matters even further. An obvious cult classic worth playing for every adventure fan. Number 10. Star Trek The Next Generation, A Final Unity. Imagine if Paramount went through their archives and discovered several unaired episodes of legendary TV series Star Trek The Next Generation. That's what finding this game felt like for me. The entire cast reprises their roles at the peak of their acting powers, and the stately pacing of the show fits perfectly with the point-and-click genre, as you boldly go where no game has gone since. Engage. Number 9. MDK. Some genres evolve over a period of time involving a lot of trial and error, but between Tomb Raider and MDK, it would appear that the third-person shooter's gameplay was perfected. You're a bizarre-looking fella called Kurt Hectic, a janitor who must single-handedly save the world from an alien invasion. MDK features incredibly responsive controls, gliding, sniping, and took the press by storm when it showed up. They knew they were looking at the future of gaming, and hindsight proves that to be oh so true. Number 8. Star Wars X-Wing. Slapping a Star Wars logo on an enhanced version of Lawrence Holland's World War II flight sims and making you do the Death Star trench run was a recipe for success. LucasArts wanted a competitor for Origins' fantastic Wing Commander series, and Larry gave them one. X-Wing is not for the faint of heart, with a huge control scheme and unforgiving missions. But it was a giant step forward for the space combat genre as a whole, and the licensing meant that the Force was with it. Number 7. Magic Carpet. Peter Molyneux's Bullfrog Entertainment had a run of DOS games from 1989 to 1997 that reads like a list of classics because almost everything they produced for the operating system was. First-person carpet simulator Magic Carpet, despite its buggy release and demanding system requirements, was an unparalleled success. You're a wizard on a magic carpet tasked with acquiring orbs, fighting other wizards and monsters, and restoring balance to the fractured chaos of multiple planes of existence. It's just as amazing as it sounds. With fully 3D terraformable landscapes and glorious pixelated enemies to battle against. A once-in-a-lifetime type of game that hasn't had a modern equivalent live up to its lofty standards. Number 6. The Need for Speed. It's difficult not to view this game in light of it being the first of what would become a massive, sprawling, and controversial franchise that made EA very rich indeed. Strip away the issues that the name conjures up and you'll find one of the finest DOS racing games out there. Whether it's time trials, full checkpoint-laden races, or just one-on-one duels, this fantastic racer delivers in spades. Number 5. Master of Magic. One of the greatest turn-based games ever released, Master of Magic puts you in the shoes of a sorcerer, competing against other sorcerers to control the world, or at least your plane of existence. And it does it in a timeless and easy to understand fashion as you move your armies about and unleash havoc with your increasingly powerful arsenal of spells. Simply put, this is essential playing for any strategy fan. Number 4, Heretic. Although it can rightfully be criticized as Doom with a fantasy skin, Heretic was an excellent shooter in its own right, and one of the first quality games on the id Tech Engine not released by id. You're an elven wizard hellbent on avenging your people by killing everything. Do you really need more of a plot than that? Sure, the weapons aren't as good and the level design can be a bit derivative, but Heretic is still a blast using the GZ Doom engine. Number 3. Master of Orion 2. You know you've done well when your game is still considered one of the greatest in the genre 25 years after its release. Everything about this 4X turn-based strategy oozes quality, from the wonderfully evocative music through to the intriguing custom ships and race relations, as you all vie to be the greatest force in the galaxy. Established diplomatic relations the likes of which would make Picard impressed, or selfishly destroy everything in your path on the way to being the supreme leader of the known universe. Number 2. Heroes of Might and Magic 2. I used to be annoyed that the Might and Magic series of RPGs was eclipsed in popularity by this weird turn-based spin-off, but after having finally played one of its definitive titles, I can now see why. This strategy game has you controlling armies, headed by heroes that grow and change over time with experience and adventures. It's also one of the most addictive one more turn games I've ever played, and you can easily dump thousands of hours into it without the slightest bit of fatigue, a must for any lovers of a genre. Number 1, One Must Fall, 2097. Possibly one of the last times I'll talk about this game, much to the relief of some subscribers who can't stand it, as it has already been featured to the point of saturation on this channel. One Must Fall 2097 is like Street Fighter 2 with giant robots, and for my money it's the best fighting game ever made. It deserves a permanent space on your hard drive. Find the time to ensure that happens, and then shear away bolts and steel with lethal flurries of kicks and punches.